Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to have two awesome games. Two amazing, amazing battles with Mr. Waffle. Yeah, this is the name of the tank, and I must admit, this is one of the better tier 9 tank destroyers, to be fair with you. It is very, very strong, it is very, very bloodyful, and everything is completely fine with this tank. Quick highlight, what I enjoyed using on this vehicle, and what was the... What is the best build, in my opinion? First of all, this is the right gun to do the things with, at least in my opinion, which is 560 alpha damage, right? It worked well because the gun was working like a bloody laser. It was so good, it's crazy how good this gun was. Plus, on top of that, if you are not, if you are thinking 280 millimeters of penetration is not enough, you can always stab the 2-key, then you are going to have a 1 mile AKA 1.5 kilometer shell velocity, and it's going to be crazy. You are going to hit everyone, right? So that was very, very, very nice thing. And I must admit, fellas, I played probably even better with Waffelcock than I am playing with Grille now, although with Grille it's still warming up progress, right? Or process, I supposed to say. Anyways, we finished Waffelcock in 101 games. We had 59% win ratio, we had 3,400 damage and 600 assisting damage, which is quite fine. And in order to get up to 100% of mark of excellence, we needed to play constantly well for 3,600 plus. That's what we needed, right? So that's what we have, my lovely friends. Beautiful. I am feeling very, very happy with all this. And fellas, you will see two bloody amazing battles, okay? So grab a popcorns for yourself and enjoy the show, because it's going to be very, very, very nice. Let's teleport into the first battle, shall we? Kaboom! We are back, my lovely friends. So what do we have here? We have the Waffelcock in pretty much the best map for a tank destroyers, and I'm going to show you a very, very well-known position from where you can get a lot of use and from where you can get shit ton of stuff. And all of those games, fellas, they were made by obviously streaming, right? I had conversation with a chat while playing the game as usual, right? So anyways, this is not the most important thing. The most important thing is the score, what we managed to do here. And you will see, Waffelcock can be a bloody ninja turtle, and it can work extremely, extremely well. Now, one tip and hint whenever you are playing in this position where I'm going to play. It's not uncommon position. Everyone knows that the hotel one red line here, right? Everyone knows this position. I believe you are very, very well aware of that. So what we are going to do, fellas, we are going to load high explosive ammunition. Skill, why high explosive ammunition? What you are doing here? Pay attention to what I'm doing, fellas. I am trying to get the right angle, and kaboom, the tree is going down. And what that means, fellas, that means we are going to have some extra protection, and now we are sitting very, very well in the bush. So from now on, to outspot us, enemies needs to get very, very close, and they actually need to pretty much outspot us, right? Or alternatively blind fire us. But since blind firing, usually what people is doing, people is blind shotting this tiny bush. And now if you would pay attention right here, the bush became so much bigger, so it's so much harder to blind fire you, right? So all you need to do whenever you are doing this couple of easy steps, you need to calm down here, and you need to bang every single person which is going through the middle, as this T-54 lightweight is doing, or alternatively this T-10 which is peaking. Plus, if it's not enough, whenever you have a light tank somewhere in front, right, you might get some free shots towards the people which is playing here, right? So from now on, fellas, it is a pure relaxation. We are just chilling in position and having our eyes widely open as a pussycat, right, for our incoming prey, aka mouse, fly, or something else, right? Doesn't really matter. So look at this. This is ideal position for any tank destroyer out there. You see, someone is trying to blind fire us, but I don't really care about that too much, unless I'm going to receive a blind shot, right? If I will receive the blind shot, then I'm going to be concerned. Obviously, alternative option would be to relocate from this position to this position and everything would be fine, but it doesn't really matter. We have all time in the world of tanks. And once again, playing with a tank destroyer, you need to be patient, fellas. You need to be very, very patient. I can guarantee you that. It's one of the most important things right here, right? So that's why some people do not enjoy playing with the tank destroyers, because they simply do not have that patience inside of them, which is once again completely understandable. Not everyone can sit in the bush for 10 minutes or so, but this is how it looks like. Also, quick highlight, Waffenträger gun so far is behaving for me better than Guerrilla gun. I had so much fun with this tank, it is bloody insane. Also, one more thing, once again, the standard penetration and the standard shell velocity is humongous on this vehicle, although Guerrilla have literally the same penetration and literally the same shell velocity. Just 750 alpha damage, but really have less alpha, less DPM, more alpha, right? And now if you are looking into the gold ammunition of this tank, 560 alpha damage, right? Which is very, very good. And you have 350 penetration. By the way, Guerrilla do not have as good penetration and Guerrilla do not have as good shell velocity. So I think, fellas, I can clearly say Waffenträger is godlike tank. It is one of the best tanks in the game. In the tier 9, speaking about the sniper schnitzels, I could easily compare this tank to Esterva, right? And Esterva is out of this world, if I can say so. But Waffenträger is more flexible, because in the city you have a turret and you can actually, you are not finding yourself into those awkward positions, right? Plus on top of that, gun elevation, whenever you are moving the gun up, there is pretty much no limits whenever you are facing frontally, right? That's the thing. If you are wondering what I'm doing here, I'm trying to knock the tree down so to confuse the enemies to blind fire somewhere else, but I am failing doing so, which is completely fine. It happens. Not much what we can do about this. I know there is no lights over there or something, right? My main idea was to knock the tree down and simply try to cut one the enemies in this way, because they will think, maybe someone is sitting in that bush, and they will start blind firing and they will waste the time in this way, right? But unfortunately, I failed doing so, and no 200 IQ for me, but that's completely fine. No complaints, no regrets. So what I was saying, fellas, if you haven't played with a Waffenträger ever, I would highly recommend you to test this vehicle out, because it is truly amazing. And if you don't like Guerrilla, and I know plenty of people do not like Guerrilla, they do not enjoy the Guerrilla, keep this in mind, fellas. Keep this in mind, the Waffenträger tier 9 is so much better tank. And like I said, even though I love Guerrilla with all my heart, there is one thing which I need to say. I need to move in front, because Bobject is making a hardcore pressure, and if I'm not going to move with him, then I won't be able to get some shots right here, right? I simply need to go together with our lemming train deer. And look at this beauty, guns everywhere, boom boom boom, left right and center, 4,200 damage, which is already great battle even for a tier 10 tanks, right? But no, my lovely friends, no, we are just starting. This is only the start for us. This battle is going to be exciting, and this battle is going to be awesome, and soon the real stuff will start. So obviously now we are just farming, right? And we are just trying to punish every single person which is making one or another bad decision. Meanwhile, the score is 6-11, so by the looks of it, we are losing this battle, right? But in the same time, we all of us splitted towards the 1-2 line, and the best thing of all, this enemies are not thinking about the capping base yet, right? So that's the thing. So everything is fine. Meanwhile, the Ruski light tank is trying to be useful, and he's trying to spot like crazy. He's moving meow, like a bloody mosquito. And all I need to do, I need to see him making mistake. And here we go. That's mistake. He stopped for a second, and now it is a game over. Now, looking into this situation, right, there is a T10 which is sniping from the back. There is Object 257 which is somewhere in the middle, right? We can definitely deal with those vehicles, and we have quite a bit of time left on the
clock, right? We have, it's pretty much 50% battle passed away, speaking about the timer, but let's see what we can do here. I'm going to take the typical bush rider because I can predict and I am hoping for enemies to start making a bit of pressure for us. And pay attention, fellas, we are not loading gold right here. We are using the standard ammunition without bigger problems whatsoever. Progetto was thinking, I will flank you, flank your ass, mother trucker. Beautiful, we was prepared for that guy, and now can we get a hitting shot for the 257? Sure thing we can. We are on 5,600 damage so far, and shout out for every single person which is doing the mission, which is doing the tank destroyer mission 8, right? When you need to do 8,000 damage, and a lot of people is thinking, how the flying F you are doing this? You are getting lucky. You can do that with a tier 9 or you can do that with a tier 10. Those two tiers are the best for this mission, but once again, you simply need to bless me. You simply need to be lucky. That's it. Nothing more than that. Meanwhile, our Bobject with 700 HP is making a bit of pressure towards the TVP, so that's not very good thing for us. But look at the bright side. We just smacked the Rhino with a full first gold ammunition right here. Rhino, since Rhino have a derpy gun handling, we don't really care about that. And we are just moving in front, right? Now I am trying to figure out how the flying F do we want to decap the base, and Object made a humongous mistake. He got decaptured, and here we go. Now we are playing. Now the situation is looking so much better, although remember there is Arta still in the game, which is not very, very good thing. 2-4 situation, fellas. We are on 7,300 damage, which is already amazing score, but in the same time, our friend is getting banged, right? And plus, it's not very clear what Object 268 or Rhino is going to do, and now it's clear what 268 is going to do. 268 is starting to making pressure towards us, right? He is thinking, oh, skill, I will beat the living crap out of you, and I'm saying, really, buddy, really? Boom, one in the face, minus 500 damage for this guy. He is down to 2 shotable for us, which is very good. I'm risking for the biscuit. I took one for the team. I don't really care, and I do not regret my decision right here, because now this guy can get completely effed, and our friend is still quite healthy, speaking about the 257. Meanwhile, Artem is the shot. We are pinging on the maxi map where the flying F Arta is to give an information for our 257, and what we are going to do now we are starting to flank this, but we are starting to flank the Rhino. But now the worst thing of all this is happening. Our 257 is not patient. He is not patient. He is not waiting until I will flank the Rhino. And how the things is looking like, fellas, he is simply making pressure like there is no tomorrow, and this is game over for him. And that was a mistake. Only if this person would wait 30 seconds more whenever we are getting into good position, it would be completely different story. Plus, on top of that, RNG said no thank you for towards the Rhino, which is quite sad thing. And if you would pay attention at the hour score, it is 8,700 damage. It is humongous score. If we would kill Rhino in TVP, we would have even better score. And now look at this, aiming fully and the bounce. Really, game, really. Skill, you could load high explosives. Yes, indeed, I could load high explosives here, but I thought I will be able to penetrate Rhino either way quite easily, but as you can see, it was not the case, and unfortunately, this is the heartbreaking situation for us, right? The moment when we needed a gun to hit, unfortunately, the gun said eat kaku, right? But it happens, you can't win them all, and we need to do what we need to do. Plus, on top of that, we are trying to get ourselves a blind shot here or something, and the main reason why I'm not loading high explosives there, because I do not know how many HP the TVP has. That's the question, you know? And I'm trying to get the shot. Meanwhile, TVP is trying to go like this. I'm aiming for TVP, and that was a shitty ass shot by me. I can't blame the tank. I cannot blame anyone else. I need to blame myself for being silly goose. Here we go. That was the first battle. It was very, very good battle. In fact, it was the best game damage-wise for Waffelcock, which we had overall. And you know what? I'm not feeling too bad about this. This battle could be victory in one particular way.
If we would go together with 257 by saying we would go together, I would relocate right there, and this guy would go and make a pressure towards Rhino, then it would be a different story. But it is how it is. Not every single person is professional World of Tanks player, so there is no complaints and no regrets. The first epic battle with a Waffelcock, and I would highly recommend you to test this vehicle yourself. If you are up for redline bushwhanking, right, you like this a bit slower gameplay when enemies are making mistakes, they are going towards you to smack them for 560 alpha damage and have a decent camo, plus to have fully rotatable turret even in the city maps, this is always good. So I would highly recommend to check this vehicle out. Anyways, that was the first battle. I told you it was a great game, okay? That was Tank Destroyer 15 mission completed, but once again, all stars was we are aligned, right? So now what we are going to do, we are teleporting into the second battle, which is going to be very, very good. Let's see, fellas, let's go. And we are back, my friends. The second battle, Magical Murovanka. I don't know how many of you are remembering the old school Magical Forest when we had a hill over there instead of having a ditch or dip or however to say that properly, and when we had very, very, very thick bushes over there. I don't know how many of you are remembering this, but I will never ever forget this this map, and it was crazy. Except if you have a smart light tank, you are going to win the battle automatically, because light tank is going through the bushes slowly like this and outspotting everyone, right? So that's how the game was looking like back in the day. Anyways, let's focus on the other things. And what do we have right here, fellas? We have Murovanka, like I said, tier 9, tier 8 matchmaking. Everything is looking beautiful. And what we are doing as a proper bushwanker, we are sitting next to the back, next to the red line, and trying to punish enemies every single time whenever they are going to do something silly or something stupid, however you prefer to call that, right? We have the T10 right here, and we are saying a big fat hello for him while playing with a Waffelcock. You can say whatever you want, but this gun handling is just simply godlike, and keep this in mind, I am not spamming the full gold. If you would spam the full gold, this tank would be even more powerful as it is now, right? If I can say so. Anyways, T10 is thinking about making pressure, but once again, we are not complaining about this. We are just simply waiting until enemies will make one or another silly goose move. That's what we need to see. Pantera, maybe. Do you want to peek, buddy? Oh yes, he wants to peek. That was a quite bad shot by me because I was not focusing on the game, but obviously that's not an excuse. But it doesn't change the fact we can still punish this Panther in the ass for 600 damage or so. Now I am preparing to escape from position while still aiming towards the enemy forces, which is a very, very important thing to say. Although hashtag never lucky the T 54 absorbed the damage with his track, but it happens, right? It's okay. Remember, fellas, this is 500 meter sniping, okay? It is not like you are playing 2 meters away and you are missing the shot as you are doing with the Rhino, right? As an example. Bad shot by me once again, can't complain whatsoever about my decision. And unfortunately, our T-54 is getting slaughtered. I was thinking, do I want to hit the T-54, but I decided not to, although since he's tracked here, spoiler alert, that's a blind shot, but I low-rolled him, which is completely understandable, all good. Everything is fine. We are over 2000 damage already, and I am not relocating from this position for one particular reason, because there is a Lynx in front, so Lynx is going to spot for us, right? Although, as you can see, I am using the bush mechanics as much as I can. I am trying to be completely covered in the bushes, right? Meanwhile, enemy Lynx is going, meow, and watch this. This is the most enjoyable part of Ferrari vehicles, to watch them die. I know sounds bad, but this is exactly how I feel like. The same T-54, which took one blind shot, but we massively low-rolled him, but it's completely fine. He is not going to live forever, is he? No, he is not. T-54 is gun, GG finito. We are sitting on 2,500 damage already, 4 minutes into the battle, to be exact, 3.5 minutes into the battle, and this Lynx is doing a humongous job. He is trying to spot
enemies which is trying to get closer to us. And as you can see, we are facing ass to the enemies. And the main reason why, so with this tank you have more gun depression in this way. Plus, I am already prepared to escape if something will go bad. If we will see many forces which is making a hardcore pressure for us, right? So that's what we are doing. And once again, there is no need for us to do anything now. All we need to do, we need to have our eyes open. And this is a typical tank destroyer gameplay, fellas. You do not have too much pressure on your shoulders, although what you need to do, you simply need to punish enemies every single time whenever they are going to mess up and whenever they are going to do one or another stupidity. So I decided to relocate completely from here, and the main reason why I'm relocating from here, because the T-30 is making a bit of pressure because our guys are capping the base, right? Plus, on top of that, we can take this position here and we can simply bang him. Although I noticed a bit different angle here, he's exposing his ass for us every single time, so we are simply knocking the house down, so he do not have a protection anymore. And now all we need to do, we need to say goodbye for a T-30. Bye bye, buddy. Easy. Beautiful performance so far. We have the 6-5 score, and watch this, fellas. That's a PP elevation which every single man wants to Anyways, going back to the battle, all we are doing here, we are going to the bushes, fellas, and we are waiting once again until enemies will mess up, and you can be sure about that, they will. So once again, patience is the key, mother truckers. Patience is the key. As wrong as it sounds. So once again, we are waiting, and Pantera, where you think you are going? I'm playing with a waffle cock. You are not going to escape. By the way, you just noticed 30 seconds ago, you just noticed why this vehicle has the cock next to his name, if you know what I mean, fellas. Beautiful, very nice. So Jack Tiger is sitting right here. We know where Jack Tiger is. We know guard can peek either like this or either like this, and we are going with some blind shots left, right and center. Maybe we are going to hit them. Right. Meanwhile, the Progetto is getting spotted. That's completely fine. I don't really mind him in the middle, because once again, to do something for the waffle is quite complicated and quite a hard thing. And once again, looking into the enemies, what do we have here? We have a Jack Tiger. We know where Jack Tiger is. We never ever seen Love, so Love can be AFK. Guard is over there. What guard? Guard just took 580 in the face. We know where Progetto is. He was sitting somewhere over there. And Estreves one never ever was spotted, but he has one kill, so more likely he's sitting somewhere around this area, this corner, right? There, this is where this guy is supposed to be. And our Lynx is making a hardcore pressure, and he just spotted Estreves, so that's very, very good. We know only Love not spotted, no kills whatsoever, so that makes sense. He can be AFK right here. And you know what, fellas? My dream is to see AFK Love. Let's see. Will my prediction or will my thought work well or not really? And what do we have here? We have a Love which is AFK. So this is pretty much the cherry on top of the cake. Everything is fine. Everything is beautiful. All we need to do, we need to bang the Love. I'm making sure I'm spotting once again, right? So I am shooting via the bush, so my camo value is still remaining the same. But after the shot, I am moving out of the bush and I'm trying to spot the Love. Once again, as you can see, Love is getting spotted, and I'm hoping for our team not to cap the base, fellas. I'm hoping for our team not to cap the base. I am asking politely for Charioteer, please leave the base. Don't be suka and don't cap the base, buddy. That's what I'm politely asking, and as you can see, Charioteer said affirmative. Charioteer, the man of the game, simply said, sure thing, I am going to leave the cap, don't you worry, skill. This is very, very rare occasion, and you can say in a way I'm a selfish bastard for asking that, because situation is not looking that great, but everything is fine, fellas. I can tell you that everything is fine. So once again, Lynx Lynx is running away. Charioteer died, and Charioteer is questioning his life choices for leaving the cap circle, right? But everything is going to be fine. That was very, very nice gesture from his side to say, okay, I see. We're about to win the battle, so why the heck not to leave the cap, right? Once again, we have shitting of the blind damage right there. I can promise you that, my lovely friends. And this is not a real score of this battle, if we can say so. Anyways, what we found here, we found the Jack Tiger moving and making pressure towards our team, and that's very good because we are having the bushes in front, and all we need to do, we need to open our eyes and we need to hit him. Pay attention how much gold ammunition we are shooting with this vehicle, and what do I want to say? I want to say we are spamming the full gold because we don't have a standard ammunition whatsoever. Such a disgusting person, right? Meanwhile, the situation is 1 versus 3. GV Tiger is getting killed. Hip hip hooray, GV Tiger is dead. Now we are trying to figure out where M5355 is. And I am betting the M5355 is somewhere around this area, right? That's what I am thinking about, and that's what I am hoping for, right? What we are going to do, we are going to speed the things up, because unfortunately the Arta is not over there, but it's completely fine. We are still relocating. Meanwhile, Progetto took one for the team, and Progetto is down to one shotable right there. And now we are playing. This is quite interesting stuff. We have quite a bit of HP left, but remember, enemy artillery can always bang us, right? That's a fact. What do I mean by saying that is Arta can simply eliminate us from the game quite easily. One hit and I am pretty much dead. But we have a plan crafted right there, right? We are going to take a very nice position right there in the bushes, right? That's all we want to do. Let's go back to the normal speed. We are moving ass first because we are enjoying this the most. Obviously, I'm messing with you, and we are doing this to have extra gun depression right idea, right? Extremely close battle, very nice, and I decided to make a bit of pressure idea. And what we are seeing in 5 seconds, let's count together. 5 4 3 2 1 0. Enemy is capping the base. What I'm immediately thinking, Progetto is capping the base 100%, but as you can see, it is not the case, my lovely friends. Progetto is not the one which is capping. So what that means, Arta is capping the base. And to be fair with you, I am not feeling too afraid of this. I am just going for the clicker, and I will try to find a good angle right there. Trying to find the angle, clicker is moving, and clicker is dead. And now, fellas, let's pick the cherry on top, and as you can see, Progetto is only one guy. I am capping the base, and Progetto is saying, what Progetto? Yep, easy game. That's how this game was looking like. We have 6,500 visible, but once again, I can tell you that it's not the case because we had quite a bit of the blind damage. And now let's try to teleport into the end game stats, right, of those two games. Once again, it was very, very nice. I am super happy about this performance, what we managed to get here. And obviously, those two games are the best games which I had with a Waffelcock, right? That's definitely the thing which I need to highlight and everything. But either way, we had a very, very nice session with this vehicle. I believe Kyler's is going to make the session starts in the end right there. He is going to cut it from the session when we went from the 95 to 100%, just like this, right? It was truly adorable gaming experience. And remember, you can see me playing live on Twitch. Usually I'm trying to read the chat all the time, although sometimes we have a try hard sessions when I'm not reading the chat that much, right? Anyways, what do we have here, my lovely friends? So let's see. Two games with this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful tier 9 vehicle. And what do we have, fellas? Let's sort everything by the damage for obvious reasons, right? And what do we have? The first battle which we played, it was extremely, extremely good. We have 8,000, pretty much 9,000 damage, 7 kills. Too bad, it's not a victory. It could be 10,000 or close to 10,000, more likely 9.5. But hey, enemies carry the game, so big fat thumbs up for them. They did everything properly, and unfortunately our friend messed up quite a bit by going earlier. But once again, it happens. Not everyone can be the best in the game, right? It just happens. And more likely this person is a new player, and if I'm not mistaken, we check at his stats after that to check how everything is looking like, and he had like 4,000 to 5,000 battles, which means he's new player, right? So yeah, anyways, we got 10,000 profits right there, which is quite a funny thing, but it is how it is. I missed quite a bit of the gold shells because I had no standards left anymore, if I remember that correctly. And after that, looking into the Moruanka score, we have a solid 8 kills. We have 7,700 damage, 800 assisting damage, 8 kills, right? We have 1.5 base experience, which is always nice and always welcome. And in the end of the day, we made quite a bit of profits, although some of them was from the mission. So, fellas, I hope you had a lot of fun watching this video. I had a blast playing with Wafflecock, and just to show you the games overall which we had with this vehicle, right? We had many great games, and I could make probably the separate video of all those other games which we had, but I am trying to cherry pick the games when I can afford it, and whenever I'm dealing with a tank, usually we are publishing this on the YouTube for you, my lovely friends. So as you can see, there is many battles, 6,000 damage, 5,000 damage. Speaking about assisting damage, probably we have quite a bit of games where we manage to spot quite a bit, right? As an example here, beautiful performance, or here 8,000 combined, you know, and so on. But I think those two games showed everything about this vehicle, my friends. So once again, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. If you enjoyed what you saw, feel free to smack the like button. It helps a lot. And thank you very much for everything, fellas. See you tomorrow. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. Peace. Ba-choo!